I'd just like to say that, you know, I think what Billy comes to the table with, he's got something that bluegrass listeners and fans and musicians alike that's been missing for a few years. What I mean by missing for a few years is like nobody else can do what Billy does, and that's what makes all great musicians, and especially bluegrass and acoustic musicians, not sound like anyone else. And when he comes to the table, when he comes on stage, he's got that thing, that it factor. Billy's a star, and you can't help but love him. And when you sit there and listen to him play, you can't help but love his music. And in fact, I usually don't get involved in a lot of new bands or stuff like that, but I really wanted to get involved with Billy because it's something that I can stand behind and I can truly believe in. He's what this music has been missing for a while, and I think he's definitely going to fill some shoes.
This song here, Kentucky Blue, is written, it was one of those songs that I felt was already written, you know, and I got in my studio one night and I kept hearing that tagline of it in my head over and over and over. And I called my brother up, he writes a little bit, and we got together and we sat there. It was about 9 or 10 o'clock at night, and it just seemed to fall out of the sky. And I know it was a blessing from the good Lord up above, you know. And that tune speaks about essentially somebody that can't get over somebody else and just doing his best to keep telling himself anything he can to live with the heartache that he's going through there. But I think it's very fitting for bluegrass music. It references, you know, Keith Whitley and Kentucky and everything that a lot of good old traditional bluegrass and just bluegrass in general is based around. And so Kentucky Blue is very exciting for me. It's got reminiscent of like old Hank Williams Sr. Melodic structure that kind of sounds reminiscent of Hank. And we just love that tune very much, and proud that we get a chance to bring it to you guys.
Kentucky Blue, bird on a record I found. Keith Whitley soothes my soul on this road I'm heading down. It ain't nothing new, the same thing I did yesterday. I'd like to leave this town, but my heart don't know the way. But I'll keep trying to dig out of this hole with a shovel in hand. But the further I go down, it feels like sinking sand. She left me down in Tennessee, along with her memory too. Now I'm Kentucky Blue. Well, I thought she cared, but it's clear to see she don't. Said she'd always be around, yeah, but I know now that she won't. So I guess I'd lose knowing her either way. I used to live for her, but I'm digging my own grave. Yeah, but I'll keep trying to dig out of this hole with a shovel in hand. But the further I go down, it feels like sinking sand. Well, she's somewhere in Bowling Green with her somebody new. And I'm Kentucky Blue. Kentucky blue. Yeah, she broke my heart in Tennessee.
I'd like to personally thank everybody at radio that's picking up the single and that's starting to spin it for us, give us a little airplay. That means more than you'll ever know. You're helping me make a lifelong dream come true, and it means a lot to me. And I just want y'all to know that if y'all are out and apt to want to give me a call and want to do a little interview, we'd be glad to do that with you and for you. And just sincerely from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much for playing my music.
I can't get enough of it. And I'm sure that everyone else is going to love it as well.
I guess you could say, as a songwriter, I kind of lucked into it. You know, out of necessity, I was able to start writing songs and learning the craft of some of the biggest and best songwriters in Nashville, like Jimmy Urie and Billy Yates, and people that kind of just really took me under their wing and taught me the craft of writing songs. And once that train started rolling down the tracks, buddy, I couldn't stop. And I've been really fortunate to get to write songs for, you know, like Flat Lonesome and the Grascals, Junior Sisk, Marty Raven, Daryl Worley, Jamie O'Neill, to list a few of the cuts that I'm really excited that I've been blessed to have over the years. And I just continue to write songs from my heart and my soul, and hopefully that I can speak to you, individual as a person, when you hear that song. It might be something that marks something that happened in your life that helps you through it, or just makes you smile. And that's what songwriting's all about, and for me anyway, and I really enjoy doing it. And so I'd like to say thank you for the folks that cut my songs, and thank you all for listening.